are you doing today? I am your host, Rich, here on behalf of Rich TV Live with our very special guest, Timothy Koh, the CEO of Entheon Biomedical Corp. How are you doing today, Timothy?
I'm doing great. Pleasure to be here.
Glad to have you on the show. Very excited to learn more about your company. Why don't we get started and you can tell us a little bit more about Entheon Biomedical Corp and what made you want to become the CEO?
Cool. Entheon Biomedical Corp is focused on the development of psychedelic molecules for the purpose of treating mental health conditions, primarily addiction. So what we're doing is we're taking pure synthetic DMT and entering into clinical trials for the purpose of, you know, facilitating these massively profound life-changing experiences that will help people like, substance use disorder sufferers really transform their belief systems about who they are so that, you know, the motivations to get better and stop using drugs, all take place internally. And so DMT is very effective in doing that. And the reasons why I'm doing this are, you know, because I've been personally touched by this. I lost a brother to drug addiction in March of 2019. And, you know, not to get into the gory details, but every conventional form of treatment that was proposed to be used was, and my family, we spent hundreds of thousands of dollars and, witnessed all of the various attempts from methadone and Suboxone, antidepressants and cognitive behavioral therapy, all layering on top and ultimately sending my brother deeper into himself and in a sort of like reactive state. And sadly, March of 2019, we lost him. And, you know, my story is, of course, very personal, but it's lived out, you know, hundreds of thousands of times by, and millions of times across the globe.
What would you say are the main focuses for Entheon Biomedical Corp in 2021? Sorry to hear about that story about your brother. Terrible. It's a tragedy. And you're right. This is a sector right now, the psychedelic sector, that can really change the world because these pharmaceutical drugs are not helping people. They're making people worse. And it's terrible. And until you've been touched by it, like you have, and I've had some friends that have also had similar fates, unfortunately. And it wasn't their fault. I remember one of my friend had a car accident. He had bad back. He gets prescribed drugs from the doctor. And before you know it, he's addicted and he's spending tens of thousands of dollars a month just to try to maintain his addiction before it was too much for him. And I've seen this over and over again. So I think what you guys are doing in the psychedelic sector is amazing because it is literally going to change lives for people all over the world. And to me, this is not a want, this is a need. So thank you for your service. And in saying that, what would you say are the major focuses now for Entheon Biomedical in the first three quarters of 2021 and beyond?
Yeah, absolutely. So we all know that the drug development pathway does take a good amount of time. You know, we anticipate it's going to take about 4 or 5 years, but there are going to be a lot of, you know, very important de-risking events founded on a foundation of science. We did very comprehensive literature reviews where we know that DMT is presumably very safe and effective for the treatment of drug addiction. Those events will proceed. You know, we will continue to further develop our preclinical programs. Ultimately, we're going to be bringing this to the FDA. And so we're trying to get ahead of that and ensure that the appropriate preclinical work is done in anticipation of our Q4 clinical trial taking place in the Netherlands. But we're also understanding that, you know, the psychedelic treatments realm isn't just this, you know, isn't just focused on the drug. And there are a lot of points of patient interaction that take place far before any drug is administered. So, you know, we're making acquisitions and investments into the different parts that are, you know, sort of currently established, the revenue generating portions of that. We've invested into a group in Austin, Texas, that's administering ketamine to patients with depression. So we, you know, seek to, further invest there, as well as get some clinical learnings and make these strategic investments that allow us to, you know, generate opportunities to create revenue in the near term. And we're also focused on the development of data-driven technology platforms that in the very near term will be helpful to physicians and patients to better bolster the sort of safety landscape of the psychedelic treatment paradigm.
Timothy, mental illness is a growing issue every day, especially with addiction increasing during these challenging times with COVID-19. So many companies are coming out with more natural remedies that are helping people deal with these growing addiction issues. Can you tell us what sets Ethion Biomedical Corp apart from the rest of the companies in the psychedelic space?
Absolutely. I think it boils down to a number of things. We have what we believe is one of the strongest advisory boards in all the psychedelic space. You know, it's led by people that represent Johns Hopkins University as well, Imperial College of London. You know, and for anyone in the know, you know, those names ring a bell because they are at the forefront of research. And so we have those people directing, you know, all the protocol development as well as the very particulars about how the drug is administered. And then beyond that, you know, DMT, we do believe is the best suited molecule for the treatment of addiction as well as mental health conditions due to the very unique nature of the molecule. Unlike longer form psychedelics like LSD, psilocybin, ayahuasca, that can take anywhere from between 4 to 12 hours, depending on the dose, during which time negative adverse reactions can take place. DMT, because it is so powerful and short acting, can be customized in terms of its time of delivery so that, you know, if a person has a negative adverse reaction, which can take place because these are such profound experiences, the physician has the ability to stop that experience and avoid any type of traumatic response. Because ultimately, we are digging into some really crucial foundational elements of the personal narrative. Unlike, you know, the longer form psychedelics, where a person can start having a very distressing experience, and then there's no really way to end that experience. So the safety profiles are wildly different. But then with DMT also, we have the ability to enable physicians and practitioners to have higher throughput, ultimately generate more revenue and help more people, which we think physicians will be looking towards.
That's great. Ethion Biomedical Corp recently has announced a few different press releases about adding Nancy Maher to the advisory board. Update on your subsidiary, Halogen Life Sciences, and approval of Vivo DMT study. Can you break down these three announcements and give us an idea of what this means for the company?
Absolutely. The in vivo DMT study is, again, to that point of, you know, we ultimately have the aim of going addressing this large unmet, this large market that is the USA. And so in anticipation of that, we're making sure that the preclinical is in a form factor that is, you know, hitting all the bases that the FDA will require of us. Nancy Maher is a really welcome addition to the Entheon team. She is the, you know, formerly C-suite executive and sort of chief data scientist at a bunch of large pharmaceutical firms, and is really helping us to shape our, you know, our data creation and data management exercises within Entheon. Though, even though we are in the early stages, you know, we do intend for us to be a, you know, a large player in the psychedelic and pharmaceutical space. And in order to do that, we have to appropriately have appropriate data measures in place to amplify the value of that data. So as new information that we create comes in, as well as sort of information from the rest of the psychedelic and pharma space, we start to get more predictive and, you know, have an insight into how DMT can help not only addiction-related issues, but potentially other, as of yet unknown, psychiatric and physiological conditions. And it's also helping to help helping to develop out our data stack in terms of some of the other fields of data that we're looking at, like EEG as well as genetics, all very useful things. But, you know, the real true power of that comes when it's, you know, appropriately combined and is intelligent. And then with Halogen Life Sciences, we're super happy to announce that the preliminary testing of the genetic test, psychedelic genetic test, is reached a point of completion and will be in commercial sales very soon, you know, opening up that revenue generating opportunity. And, you know, that is a part of our commitment to the safety standards of the psychedelic industry. Right now, there isn't much dictating to a physician or a patient whether they're appropriate to take certain psychedelics. And so the Halogen Life Sciences genetic test will tell you to a pretty great degree of certainty if you have genetic biomarkers that will indicate predisposition to negative adverse reactions. And we think that's a very useful tool as more people onboard into the psychedelic space.
Can you tell us about Entheon Biomedical Corp's path to revenue, and what are some projections for 2021 and beyond?
Yeah, so the path to revenue for the core DMP project will be, of course, you know, the time horizon on that is 4 or 5 years away. Of course, de-risking events will take place in that time. But yeah, we understand that there are revenue necessities in the interim, and we don't want to generate those revenue opportunities just out of nowhere and in sort of ways that aren't value additive to our narrative. So we have identified some currently existing market gaps in terms of safety as well as diagnosis. And so, like I mentioned, the Halogen Life Sciences test is our ability to, you know, provide that to the industry that is revenue generative for us. But we're also looking into the utilization of technologies such as EEG to develop out an intelligence platform that in the near term can be used for the purposes of, you know, psychedelic assessment and personalizing a course of care. And as we have more people and more molecules coming online, you know, we have clinic networks that are popping up all over Canada, the US and abroad. You know, physicians will be faced with a choice in terms of, hey, a person has walked into my office and says they suffer from a condition. Of the molecules, whether it's MDMA, ketamine, psilocybin, or DMT, of these options that are available to me, what is the appropriate choice to make for this patient ultimately to maximize their potential for sort of relief? And so right now, a lot of that is based on subjective measures. What we're proposing to do is create an empirical way of analyzing individual patients on a genetics as well as a sort of brain architecture perspective so that physicians can make those informed data-backed choices in terms of personalizing that care to both avoid negative adverse reactions as well as to potentiate the possibility of, you know, having a positive experience.
I'm really excited about seeing what you guys can do with DMT. I don't believe there's another company out there doing DMT research that's public. Is there?
No, currently, no. There are other people that are entering the DMT space, you know, for good reason. DMT, for all the reasons that we mentioned, it being powerful, short-acting, as well as really well-tolerated by the human body. You know, it's believed that the human body actually produces DMT and so has a very natural way of metabolizing it. Of course, we're going to see other people jump into the space and, you know, try to capture a portion of its efficacy. And so we're actually, you know, happy to have other people validate our molecule choice. But for us, you know, our primary focus being those, the millions that suffer from addiction, you know, we don't feel that there's any crowding that encroaches onto our space. And it is a very massive need that we're happy to address.
So Rich TV Live has investors and members in well over 100 countries worldwide that will be watching this video. It's very important to us to have a tight share structure. One of the things that really caught my attention about Ethion is the share structure is great. You guys have a very great share structure. So can you explain a little bit about your share structure and how much is held by insiders?
Yeah, we have about 54 million shares that are about outstanding, fully diluted. I think we're at about 67 million shares. And of those shares, you're correct, it is very tightly held. And of the insiders, we insiders hold about somewhere in the range of about 3.1 million shares. And so, yeah, that is a very tightly held structure. And yeah, we think it's that was sort of consciously decided in early days. And so we weren't desperate for money. And so we were very selective about how that was structured.
And I like the way you structured it. To me, anything under 100 million is tight. Anything 50 million or less is just bingo for us in our community. So when I saw that 54 million fully diluted, 66, 67 million, I was like, wow, I like the share structure. So everything looks good from that perspective. If a shareholder, if you wanted to give a message to a shareholder, what would that be? What would be the message to a shareholder or an investor that's, you know, thinking about buying the stock? What would be the message?
Really great question. You know, what I would say is that we're the psychedelic industry in totality is very much in its early days. You know, I do think, you know, there is a huge potential for psychedelics to upend the paradigm of how mental health is treated and approached. And molecules such as psilocybin, primarily DMT, have an opportunity to really absorb market share for some of these super ineffective treatments that exist. The place that's very personal to me, the addiction treatment model is a multi-billion dollar model. And it has a massive population size that is in need of that treatment, but doesn't get it. Roughly only one in seven people that needs any form of addiction treatment actually gets it. And then the efficacy rate for those that actually do get it can range anywhere from 5 to 20%. With psychedelics, we really see the opportunity to absolutely have head and shoulders above that efficacy rates at price points that are, you know, comparable or even less than an already well-established high price point paradigm with the world of drug treatments. And so that being the sort of future state that we envision, we're also investing in all the infrastructure that is needed for us to really grow into a massive market cap company, really taking a very directed approach to data and the science around that, as well as developing out the future of what we believe is a personalized medicine approach that not only provides a medicine, but really looks at the individual and ensures that their chances of having a successful treatment are managed in an evidence-backed, data-based way. And so early days, but we're building all the necessary foundational layers that, you know, we believe will give us strength in the, you know, 5 and 10 year point hereafter.
Timothy, we're going to have a lot of investors that are going to be very interested in getting in contact with you, potentially other psychedelic companies that might want to do a joint venture or partnership. We've talked to a lot of psychedelic companies, a lot of companies in general, so they're going to be seeing this video too. What's the best way for those investors or potential partners to get in contact with you?
Yeah, and you can reach out to our IR. That is Joe at Entheon Biomedical. That's J-O-E at E-N-T-H-B-I-O-M-E-D-I-C-A-L.com. But also, you know, we encourage everyone to sign up to our socials, as well as visit our website and sign up for the newsletter. You know, psychedelics are a pretty big concept. It takes into account a lot of complexity from both the science perspective as well as the individual patient perspective. So as we make these developments, we're really eager to have people in the stream of that information. So as these very exciting developments take shape, they can be the first to hear about it.
Well, super excited to learn more and watch the company evolve. We're here today with CEO of Entheon Biomedical Corp, Timothy Koh. If you guys like the video, please smash the like button, comment down below, share the video, and subscribe. Remember, Rich TV Live is strictly for education and entertainment purposes. Always do your due diligence. Always do your research before you invest in anything that we talk about. Consult a financial advisor. Chances are when you consult a financial advisor, your financial advisor is going to say, wow, this is a really great pick. Where'd you find this pick? And you can say, from my boy, Rich. Thank you so much, Timothy. Keep up the great work. I think you're doing great work, my friend. And our entire community will be watching the story evolve.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys for watching. Have yourselves a nice day.